Dear friends, I am Parvinder from West Highlander and I welcome you all in this video about new updates about New Zealand Green List courses and post-study work visa. In this video, I would be covering three important points. The first one is the non-degree courses at level 6 and level 7 of New Zealand qualification framework eligible for post-study work visa. The second one is the duration of the post-study work visa. And the third one is the condition which the students need to follow on post-study work visa. So if you are a student looking forward to study in New Zealand, this video could be helpful to you. As per the policy, if you would like to study a course, a non-degree course at level 6 or level 7 of New Zealand qualification framework, then to be eligible for a post-study work visa after completion of the course must be on the green list. If the course is not on the green list, then you may not be eligible for a post-study work visa. The second point to take care is about the duration of the course. The duration of the post-study work visa would be equal to the duration of the course. So if you choose to do a course which is a non-degree course at level 6, so let's say that the duration of the course is of 2 years, then you would be eligible for a post-study work visa of 2 years. Similarly, if the duration of the course is of 1 year, the post-study work visa would be of 1 year. The third point is that while on post-study work visa, the students must take up a job related to the qualification they have done. So these are the conditions which the students need to follow. I would like to clarify these points with certain examples. One of the courses which features in green list is a graduate diploma at level 7 in highway engineering and civil engineering. So if you wish to do this course, then you would be eligible for a post-study work visa after successful completion of the course. Furthermore, as the duration of the course is of 1 year, you would be getting a post-study work visa of 1 year. Another condition is that you must take up a job related to your qualification. The job related to your qualification, that is graduate diploma in highway engineering, could be construction project management. This is one of the examples. Another example is of a course, graduate diploma at level 7 in construction or construction management. So as the duration of this course is of 1 year, after the completion of the course, the students would be eligible for a post-study work visa of 1 year. As per the policy, while on post-study work visa, the students must take up a job which is closely related to the qualification. The job could be of a construction project manager. Another example could be of a course at level 7, that is graduate diploma in teaching early childhood education. This is the course which features in the green list, and after the completion of the course, the students are eligible for a post-study work visa. As this graduate diploma in teaching early childhood education is of 1 year, as per the policy, the students would be eligible for a post-study work visa of 1 year. Further, the students must take up a job which is closely related to this qualification. The example of a job could be of early childhood education teacher. New Zealand diploma in engineering at level 6 is another course which is on the green list. As the duration of the course is of 2 years, after the successful completion of the course, the students are eligible for a post-study work visa of 2 years. As per the policy, the students must undertake a job which is closely related to this qualification. The job could be of a civil engineering technician and a similar job. Another course is a New Zealand diploma in electronics engineering at level 6. As the duration of the course is of 2 years, the students would be eligible for a post-study work visa of 2 years, and a job closely related to this qualification could be of an electronics engineering technician. Similarly, a New Zealand diploma in electrical engineering at level 6 is also on the green list. As the duration of the course is of 2 years, the students would be eligible for a post-study work visa of 2 years. The students must take a job which is closely related to a qualification. The job could be of a electrical engineering technician. So these were few of the examples of the courses on the green list along with the duration as well as the related job designations. Friends, I hope you find this video useful. For any query you may have about your study in New Zealand, please contact West Highlander. We are a team of experienced and expert counselors who can help you with the process. Thank you.